And we decided to come to town on Grimsby because I don't see them right now, but there is a young family that moved from Orangeville here and they wanted to introduce themselves to you. What better way but through food? When they come, I'll tell you who they are. I think he's welcoming people downstairs. For me, all of my life I'm vegetarian. I don't know anything better than that. My mother was vegetarian. I am vegetarian because I want to be healthy, but at the same time, this is my personal opinion, and please don't take me wrong, but I do believe in biblical creation, and when man was created, crown of creation, creator prescribed diet for him. And this was vegetables, fruits, nuts, seeds, legumes, stuff like that. So, again, this is my personal opinion. You are here to learn just how to eat properly. There are people out there that can afford any kind of best piece of meat, but they decided to go on plant-based diet because it's much healthier for you and we all want to live longer on this earth. I don't know why, but we enjoy it. Today, we are privileged to have a visitor from California. He used to live in Canada. Now he's in California. A couple of years ago, I think he had a quite successful cooking demonstrations in British Columbia, Vancouver area. He's quite energetic. You will see in a minute. And I would like to introduce Lydia to the Royal.
Okay, thank you. Hey. Well, thank you very much. I really feel overwhelmed. I don't deserve those. But however, good afternoon, all of you, my co-fellow and co-nationals, Canadians. I'm dual citizen, I'm living in California. It's a good weather there. However, I still miss Canada. I've been here for at least six years and a half, some back in time. So I'm coming once in a while in Canada to remember how I've been adopted by this country. And I'm very, very grateful to the country to be called Canadian. Now, because I work with people, and usually I enjoy sharing good news. I don't believe that selfishness is a good quality of character, is that true? So if you know something good about something, can we be so selfish to hide those things from people around us? Now, today I have a friend, it brought me to a vegan restaurant, four kind of restaurants in the entire Canada. And the guy says, listen, I'm not selfish. I want to share with you this kind of the, everybody's looking for good food, yes? Good quality food. So today in the afternoon, I would like to share a little bit to incriminate myself. I want to say that I was a food addicted individual. And today's subject is right, oh, we changed that? I didn't know. Okay, so I wanna express a little bit. The most powerful food in the world is the right choice. Yes, why? Because look, here is a Guinness book. This young fellow wants to eat a burger bigger than his head. Why? Just because he wants to stay in history. So he has two options: to eat a burger bigger than his head and destroy himself, but his name would be like a hero in Guinness book. What do you choose? So we eat to live. We don't eat a live to eat, basically. That's my concept. Now, when we define health, there are thousands of definitions regarding what health may be, correct? I mean, people have different versions, and I would like to stay original. In order to achieve absolute health, we need a proper diet, proper life dynamics, or lifestyle, movements, exercise, and proper thinking. This is very, very important because without proper thinking, you can drink carrot juice and hate people. If you have, or I have, a malefic mind, and I nourish my minds with evil thoughts, I tell you, that destroys our health. So it is very important, ladies and gentlemen, to take the full concept of absolute health means absolute perfect thinking. So proper diet is just 35% of the health, the physical exercise. We are taxi generation. You know, people are going to Walmart and they're looking for the closest parking spot to the entry of the market. They want to walk less. And that's why I do believe that we have a problem. You move, you exist. You don't move, you don't exist. That's a law of physics. So physical exercise is another component that is so important for preserving a good quality lifestyle. So diet, yes. But if we had a good diet and we spend 12 hours in the inside room with the ion kind of AC or air condition and doing just this, for sure we will get health issues. So I do believe in creation too, and I believe that we have to do exercise, we have to perspire. There are thousands of reasons that we have to perspire every day to open our skin, and we, you know, that we breathe through skin as well. Yeah, so perspiring open the pores, makes our breathing better and eliminate toxins and so on and so forth. Then proper thinking. You know, love patience, love people, try to have positive thinking, positive attitude, laugh all the time, be in good mood, educate mind to stay positive, nourish hope. That's part of health. So this is me 4 years ago. I was 240 pounds. My health was a mess. So that's why I try to incriminate myself. I don't want to picture myself in any kind of saint. I don't want to be canonized. I'm just a simple human being. I'm living by the grace of God, if you wish. You know, and I didn't realize, even though I was telling people about hope, I was speaking to people about freedom, and I did not realize that I was food addicted. So here is me in 2009, March 3rd, 240 pounds. I barely was breathing. I had big cramps on the chest. I could not breathe properly. I was in an extraordinary heart condition, I was just about to die. What is very important is that in the same time, ladies and gentlemen, I was claiming that I am vegetarian. For 30 years, I was vegetarian, and my lifestyle was a mess. And you know, when you look to my belly, and those are veggies. Okay. Now, I'm not promoting neither vegetarianism. I'm not promoting veganism. You know, for instance, vegetarianism can be anything outside of meat area, correct? But we can have damaging our health based on dairy products, fried things, even veganism. Veganism is a religion. I don't worship apples. You know, with all my respect, I'm a vegan. I'm plant-based diet individual, but I don't worship the mother nature. I worship the father of the mother nature. It's quite a little bit of difference. You know, many people worship nature. I bite an apple, I worship an apple. An apple is an apple. I thank the Lord, God, He created an apple. That's me. So a vegan can eat chocolate, can drink Coca-Cola. It's non-animal, non-dairy product. So I'm not promoting neither kind of rituals, religious rituals in behalf of a food or lifestyle. I do believe that, however, we can build a logical lifestyle based on right principles. So my diet was 4 eggs. You know, do you know that 1 egg, I was eating 4 eggs, goat cheese and French fries, 4,000 calories, at least 3 times per day, per week. And I was doing just computer reading, and I was becoming more and more in a condition that I could not survive. I barely had a chance to tie my shoes. You know, walking 50 meters or 150 feet, I was embarrassed before my kids, my wife, and especially because I do believe I have a beautiful wife. She said, "Listen, Livio, you will never get rid of these 80 pounds. And here I am, by the grace of God, I do believe that God can handle our willpower, because many people have good intentions. I do believe that you met people that are alcoholics. They depend on alcohol. They would like to get rid of alcohol, but they are missing what? The willpower. Smoke addicted people, they know that cigarette is not good. They want to get rid of cigarette. They have no what? Willpower. I believe that food addiction is as dangerous as cigarettes, alcohol, drugs, and any kind of addictions in this world. And I do believe that the source of power to rebuild our will to say no to bad things comes from God. In 3 years, I gave up these four eggs, goat cheese, and French fries. I want to tell you something. I ate my eggs for 500 years in advance. So when people ask me, do you eat eggs? No, I ate my portion, you know. So like an alcoholic, I'm not going to, just a little bit of an egg. You know, you have an alcoholic keeping him in 6 months, you know, cleansing diet and stuff. And you come with a little bit of whiskey, you just a little bit. What would happen with that alcoholic? Go back in the same mess. So why? Because in our brain, we form neuronal patterns. A, B, simple. And our brain works on our pleasure. You want to be happy? X, Y, G, Z? That's okay. What do you want? Candy. Okay, I will make a program here in your brain, and when I see candy, I will let you know. Boop, 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 bingo, and I eat candy like crazy. So, you know, that's the way that the brain works. So now, I ate my eggs for 500 years in advance. What people don't know is that one egg contains the quantity of cholesterol that your liver produces in 1 week. So when we eat one egg, in fact, we are bullying our liver. We need cholesterol, don't take me wrong, but our cholesterol created by our own body. So when you, I was eating four eggs. Imagine how much cholesterol I had. In fact, my cholesterol was around 287, close to 300. I was a mess. So that was the French fries, goat cheese, and cheese for me, it was like meat. I could not give up cheese because cheese is so important. I don't know exactly. Do you know why the little animal comes back to mommy when it drinks milk? Because the milk contains a biochemical substance called casein. And casein creates dependence. You have these caffeine, cocaine, nicotine, casein, purine, everything that ends in this are major fat indicators that create dependence. You know, caffeine creates dependence, yes? Casein creates dependence. And the little one goes to the mommy to suck more. So that's why when we start to eat more dairy products like milk, cheese, and so on and so forth, we feel more and more the need. For me, beat me 1 week in a row, I will not give up my four eggs, goat cheese, and French fries, you know. And my goat cheese was from Israel, kosher, super healthy, super everything. And my cholesterol was 287. Now, have you ever seen a fat liver? How a liver looks like with cholesterol 300? Have you ever seen? Because the liver is the one, the factory that dispatches the needs in the entire body. It's one of the most majestic laboratories we have in the body, correct? Look how a fat liver looks. This is the fat liver, and this is the normal liver, okay? So that was me 4 years ago. 300 cholesterol, it was a mess. The acidity in the body, I was 5. Meaning that immune system is totally suppressed. I was 1 inch to heart attack, 1 inch to cancer. Because when you have such a mess and the immune system doesn't work, you can be accessible to any kind of bacteria, virus, and so forth. So I did not even know that I have food addiction, which means food poisoning. Do you like this gentleman? So he has a remote control, meaning that he's controlled by media. You know, those people who believe that they are getting educated by the TV, they are really in the wrong pattern. In fact, the guy that is mastering the media in the United States was asked once by a journalist, well, you are making big money on TV shows and stuff like that. How much time do you watch in TV? He says, do you think I'm stupid? I have a life to live. So the guy that is mastering media in the United States, he doesn't have time to spend in his TV. I said, I have a life to live. You know? So manipulated by media, you eat more protein. You need more protein. You know, we are so manipulated. You see a guy running, you know, an athlete. They pay good money to an athlete. He's well-shaped, skinny, stuff like that. He runs, he perspires, and all of a sudden, out of the middle of nowhere, poof, a Coca-Cola in his hand, and he's drinking the Coca-Cola. The little kid is watching that advertisement moment. He says, "Mommy, I need to drink Coca-Cola because I want to be like, run like that guy." That's the subliminal message you receive. So, unfortunately, we are living in a society, we have two pillars, the food industry and pharmaceutical industry. The food industry feeds you to get poison, and the pharmaceutical industry will give you pills for the rest of your life. So here is a civilized, super civilized slavery. My friends, ladies and gentlemen, with all my due respect, I do believe in freedom. And I do believe that this is the major point most of the people in society are missing. You see, that's life. The guy with the last piece of pizza, you know, breaks the tiny. I was there. I did not know that I was food addicted. And this is basically, I don't know exactly if you heard, dopamine. Dopamine, it's a hormone that creates or elevates the level of pleasure in our brain. Every time we eat something we like, that hormone stimulates more and more and more. So that's why we have tendency, those that are food addicted, they have the tendency to eat more and eat more and eat more and eat more. Why? Because dopamine. I want to tell you, cocaine, which is one of the most powerful drugs, elevates the level of dopamine for 200 times more than is necessary in our brain. Food does the same thing. And that's why you have these junk food restaurants around. They put their a combination of three elements: salt, sugar, and fats, engineered properly in laboratories. They create dependence. This is the atomic bomb for human health. They know very well to engineer, to create the gymnastics between these three elements that destroy the human body and human health: salt, sugar, and fats. If they produce the perfect formula for your hormone called dopamine, you are addicted to that restaurant. It doesn't matter the quality. Yummy, it's good. So we don't have that sensor, you know, well, it's good, but it's healthy. You know, and I don't know exactly if you know, the stomach has two sensors. One is here, and one is in the beginning of the stomach. One is the pressure sensor. The other one is the density sensor, which means that one verifies the quality of your food that you intake, and the other one tells you stop eating, it's too much. Now, this stomach, which I do believe is created by God in such a marvelous way, do you know that your stomach is late 20 minutes to respond to your food if you bake, cook, fry your food? If you eat raw food, you know, less exposure to temperature, better quality of your food. Fruits and vegetables, nuts and grains. This is a plant-based diet that is so simple. The more a lady spends in a kitchen, the less quality that food will have. Boiling, frying, baking will kill 42% to 46% of the nutrients of the original food. So I do believe that your stomach will work in proper time. These two sensors, the pressure and the density sensors of our stomach, works properly only when you start to eat something raw. So in the morning, eat your fruits in the beginning, and your sensors will start to work in time like a clock. And in the afternoon, when you have your big greens and salads, you do the same thing. Your sensors will operate properly. When we eat baked, cooked food in the beginning, the sensors will run. The sensors will run 20 minutes later. When we start to burp, I'm sorry, you know, that's late. The brain starts to say, man, stop. We already double take the quantity of food in our stomach. But that's a different story. Dopamine is the happiness hormone, and we eat to be happy. Now, as a result of this, I have 30% of adults are obese in worldwide, and from three children, one is obese or overweight. In 2016, they project, my dear friends, over 2.3 billion overweight or society, and 700 million obese. That's because of what? An average North American eats 15 cows per year, 12 hogs, 900 chickens, 12 sheep, 1,000 pounds of other kind of meats, and so on and so forth. So do you think that this is right to eat so much protein? Now, I would like to go a little bit farther. I gave up this. I want to tell you my story when I quit all the fats. When the doctor told me, listen, man, if you don't change your lifestyle, you're gonna die. I have 5 children. I have a beautiful wife. Sure, you are sorry to die, yes, prematurely. I'm close to 50 right now. So I cut all these fats. I stopped eating meat for 30 years, but I replaced meat with this. And I was abusing my liver. And I cut this, I cut this, I cut this, and I was so good. Guess what? In 7 months, changing diet, giving up refined carbohydrates, no white flour. This is one of the curses of humanity, modern civilization, because white flour and other processed and refined foods will produce constipation, delaying the intestinal transit and creating a reabsorption of toxins at the colon level. So when we have a slow intestinal transit, you know what happens? Colon cancer. In America, every 45 seconds, one guy dies of heart attack. Every 37 seconds, someone discovers he has cancer. Every 28 seconds, somebody gets diabetes. These are the three major diseases that are flowing around via media, television, in our stores. So white flour, white everything is not good. If we can replace white with integral, you know, with everything that has fiber, you know, God has a, there is a definition about family. I know that is very controversial in North America, what family is. You can marry cats, dogs, whatever you want now. But biblically, and I'm a traditionalist, okay? Biblically, I do believe that marriage is between man and woman. And one man, one woman, okay? Now, what is very interesting, that God says, what God united, man should not separate. So I do believe in sacredness of marriage. But this formula, if God put something together, man and woman, that formula works for diets too. We do have these GMOs right now, okay? Genetically engineered or modified seeds. You know, we have instead of 3 tons of wheat, we will have 20 tons of wheat. So it's good to engineer the seed, and then we create a much more production for population. Guess what? Beside this modification of the seed, you get the allergies for gluten, correct? Is somebody allergic to gluten right here? No. You know what it happens? You thank to the guys from Monsanto's. These guys are modifying the seed and increases the level of gluten in your seed 20 times more. So when you eat that GMO, genetically modified seed, whatever is flour, this or that, you know, you get 20 times more gluten than your body can handle. And then your immune system overreacts, and we develop what? Autoimmune diseases. You have got coxarthrosis, osteoporosis, all kind of oses. Because the body, you know, you have immune system is like an army, correct? Immune system is like an army. And immune system is designed to defend you. But after so much garbage we trash, I mean, I'm incriminating myself. I was the mess, okay? So I put so much garbage in me that my immune system didn't work. It said, leave you, you're completely crazy. What do you do with me? I refuse to recognize you as my leader. You're crazy. So the immune system turns the gun against you. Then we developed allergies. Allergies are nothing more but the reaction of our immune system to the way that we treat our body. So we have a lot of allergies because you have GMOs. You know, half tomato, half bug. You don't know what is a mosquito, you know, because they can create. And the immune system goes there to search what you eat. Man, somebody says it's a tomato. No, it's not a tomato. It's a mosquito, a gene from mosquito. I don't know what you are. And then we have reactions of this nature, genetically modified things. Now, I want to tell you something. Do you know that we are manipulated By media, you have to eat a lot. You get skinny if you don't eat milk, eggs, cheese, meat. You need that protein to get to become 360 pounds. Is that true? Let me tell you something. I don't know exactly. I'm coming from Europe. I was born in Romania back in time. People know about Romania three things: Ceausescu, Dracula, and Nadia Comăneci. That's all about my country, you know, nothing fancy. However, what is very interesting, this is Norway, yes, Europe. So, good guys, they have a lot of cows, cattle, sheep, goats, and so on and so forth. Now, I want to show you something. They were doing beautifully great. In 1927, Norway started to prosper economically. So they were drinking more milk. And this is 1935, when the Germans start to assess them. And what happens is they go up and up. In 1940, German Nazi conquers Norway, okay? So no, you know what happens? They take all the cattle, all the cows, the entire food production from Norway, and let these people starve. Now, I will give you a definition. Starvation is fasting. Is that true? When you don't eat, basically what are you gonna do? You fast. Fasting, you heard about fasting, yeah? So starvation equals fasting. So the Norway people, they were taking the cow, the cattle, the milk, the eggs, the chickens, the everything. Guess what? The rate of heart attack at this point was to the mortality from circulatory disease, Norway 1927, 1948. Death rate per 10,000 people. So here is the highest rate of heart attack in Norway society. When Hitler came and took all the milk and the sugar and the fats and the eggs from them, the heart attack decreased. They start to fast. So my question is, and when the Second World War ended, 1944, 1945, they start to go up again because the Norway people got back the cows, the cattle, the goats, and so on and so forth. So my question is, do you know that more people get sick because overeating than less eating? We are always having this phobia. Oh, I didn't eat enough. I tell you, one day per week fasting, it's an extraordinary preventory treatment for our body. We get sick for more food than less food. In fact, in the World War II, they discovered today the longest generation of people in Canada, North America, Europe, that were engaged in the war. They were those who were starving for months and weeks because they didn't have anything to eat. You know what they did? They did cleansing. They were eating fruits, a little bit of vegetables here, and they are 94, 95, 98 years of age right now. These guys, they are still alive. Why? Because in this wartime, the kids, they were children at that time, okay? So they developed the discipline to survive with less food than more food. And they developed a custom, a habit, a way of living, a lifestyle. And here are these guys from born in 1941, and they're 90 some years of age, and they're still alive. But no, our generation is. So what I wanna say, when I saw myself when I was 240 pounds, an apple and a donuts, what do you think I would choose? What you would choose? You know, sugars, fats, and salts, there are. I don't need apple. I will take that. You need 10 seconds to decide, okay? Life changes, and I changed. You know, when you change things in life, especially starting with a diet, with the dynamics of life, you know, physical exercise, you change your thinking. You know, people say, you are different. You are different than before. And make a move. That's our choice today. Now, what is very important, ladies, who takes charge of your kitchen holds the destiny of your health. Do you think that is so? How many kings in dark ages were killed by the wives? They put some nice, funny things in their food, and they were eating like crazy, and that was the end, you know? So history and the present proves that who takes charge of your kitchen who takes hold of the destiny of your health. So this is my diet in the present time. Fruits, vegetables, nuts. I eat as less cooked food as possible. When I'm not a saint, I don't say, but you make a habit of that. The more raw we eat, the better we look. So now I can run. I can do my push-ups. By the way, I can do my push-ups, and I feel very good. You know, it's not about being vegan, vegetarian, and this and that. It's about the quality of your life. Do you want to live another 30, 40 years? Somebody says, you know what, sir, with all my respect, you can eat your bananas. You still have to die. Yes, it is true. I have to die if I eat my bananas and fruits and so on and so forth. But the problem is, what quality of your life you may have. You know, it's one thing to grab your mess in from hospital to another hospital, and rather to be dependent on the system and have this beautiful lifestyle quality. So this is the oils that are the best. This is the oils that you can eat without having any problem with oxidation. You know, we for instance, for one tablespoon of oil, you need 40 olives. Do you know that it takes 40 olives to fry them well and squeeze them to get one tablespoon of oil? Do you know how many calories? You ask Mr. Google and ask how many calories you have a tablespoon of oil? Almost 200 calories, 189, 192, depends how big that tablespoon is. And if you put 4 tablespoons of oils, that's already all 800 calories. That's supposed to be the amount of calories you intake for one meal. So oil, it's empty calories. Sugar, the same thing. Sugar is empty calories. So why we are getting overweight? Coca-Cola, all the type of sodas, you know, you have 24 teaspoons of sugar in a Coca-Cola. The body gets crazy, you know. Look at this. Low-fat thick Newtons. You know the Newtons, yes? 140 calories. If you eat a cantaloupe fully, it's 140 calories. Now, how many low-fat Newtons we may eat once? Two? Come on, everybody, when open a bag with this stuff to a kid, how many does he eat? Two? Nobody will eat two. How about gummy bears? Look, 4 ounces of gummy bear, 450 calories. You need to eat a pineapple to get to that calorie. So you understand why we are booming with obesity, because we are eating processed carbohydrates that have a high caloric index. You know, we eat more calories than we burn. And when we stay fresh, we stay Mother Nature, we believe in the Father of the Mother Nature. And you have 200 calories. You need to eat this big plate of celery. You know, who eats that so much? You cannot eat, it's too much. It's just 200 calories. If you go farther, you have a little bit of chocolate, just a little bit of chocolate, 200 calories. You have to eat that plate full of green peppers or red peppers, whatever. Now, how about the crackers? You know, you need to eat a big plate of broccoli to equalize 200 calories from here. So people are eating this. That's why they get fat, because they triple the quantity of food, and nobody wants that. Especially when we eat this, we don't like this. I was that. You know, when you eat perverted food, fried stuff, our taste is perverted. That's the reality. And we have hard time to change appetite. I would never believe in my life that I would stay away from eggs. For me, 4 eggs, goat cheese, French fries, that was my religion. You cannot take that away from me. But when I saw myself face to face with death, I realized that life have different dimensions than food, correct? So 700 calories, pasta. You know, people like pasta. Cut two of these and add just vegetables, and you will have 40% almost less calories. So if you get in much raw fruits in the morning, vegetables in the afternoon, I mean, we get better fitted with that. Now we are generation taxi generation. This is an advertisement in the United States. This guy has over 350 pounds. You know what the junk food restaurants advertise? If you reach the level of 350 pounds, you come and eat for free. So there are people that take that story true. So they eat, they eat, they eat until they develop these 350 pounds. And then they go to the restaurant, put me on the weight. And I have 350 pounds. Now we give you burgers for free. They eat burgers, French fries for another 3 weeks. Boof. And they are called by the cemetery system. You know, so this, we are living in a generation of manipulated people, you know, so we have to conclude today our presentation and realize that 40% of the population lives like this in the car. We need to change our lifestyle and to decide, do you want to be what? Do you want to be dead 24 hours or do your physical exercise half an hour? And my last picture is this. Do you see? This is America in a cinema in 1929, recession time. Tell me how many overweight people you see here. No, because at that time there was no GMO, there was not so much artificial food. Americans were living like this. That was the taxi, yes? That was the food that we're eating. They were eating, working in a farm. They were burning their calories. The kids didn't have cell phones and iPhones and all this. The kids were working, you see. That's a family. Who is overweight here in this family? They have four or five kids. Wife looks beautiful, like top model. Man, like Cassius Clay, you know. This is the farm. This is the time when people were not ashamed to pray. Today, we kick God out of our schools, out of everything. We become overweight and we are God ourselves. Ladies and gentlemen, let's think positive. This is my wish and prayer for all of you. And thank you. And I would invite you to the next session, Living Food. Thank you. Yeah, so my last few minutes, because I have some ladies that really will trail you with some recipes here. That's not my expertise. I am completely illiterate. But I want to testify, I ate in the house of this lady that he will cook. Yeah, well, okay, we will. Yeah, so what we will do is, I have a breakfast for you, and always fruits in the morning, because you have a lot of sugar, glucose that is needed for the brain. So this is a simple, you like fruits? You know, this machine is not very expensive. You can add some pineapple. Pineapple is very good for those who want to lose weight. If you put that pineapple here, and then you put some other, I don't go more than four fruits. You know, you add some little bit of cantaloupe, and if you want to have some apple is very good. You know that apple is called the king of the fruits, correct? And then you put a little bit of that, and one of these three items can be mixed according to your pleasure. And then if we want to put, for the sake of pleasure, more liquid, I don't know exactly, we have rice or something to, okay, yeah, a little bit. We can put water or soy milk, rice milk, or almonds milk. It depends, you want to drink smoothie or you want to eat the smoothie. So that is very important. We put a little bit of this. Rice is very good because you don't have much protein in that, and I don't want to overcharge you with protein. So we put a little bit, probably 30% of liquid in here, and then we create our smoothie. It takes 5 minutes to stay at online to McDonald's. I think it takes 12 minutes. How much is a burger in McDonald's now and French fries? Well, what is the, I don't know the price because I've never been. I've been for a long. How do we charge this?
Just to make sure it's...
Yeah, it is. It is, but where is it? Oh, okay. So, we eat... That's it. So, if we have this, you can drink as much as you want from this. You can drink like... 2 cups, 3 cups is not a problem your body can handle if you overdrink this. In 20 minutes, they get in the system. If you have your nuts, if you have beside this some nuts, do you like oatmeal? My wife was working for an 84 years old lady in one of the houses, and for the first time she went to the doctor and says, "Sir, I have a problem with the shoulder." She says, "How old are you?" 84. And she says, "So you never been to the doctor?" "No." "What did you eat in the morning?" "All my life, oatmeal." So she was, poor lady, she didn't have money, you know, but she was there. So you have this, just, we will taste that. And a little bit of nuts, You know, because that's your oil. And a starch, even all wheat bread, toasted. By the way, one slice of bread is at 120 calories. If you toast, you drop 20 calories from that. So ladies, if you really want to do in a whatever diet, toast the bread and you eat less calories. Yes, please.
I would like just to add, I don't want to be rude or anything, I would like to add two things to the smoothies recommended by the doctor.
Okay.
It's a flax seeds and sesame seeds. One spoon of sesame seeds and one spoon of flax seeds into the smoothies, that's a perfect combination.
Yes, absolutely. Actually, this is a good point. So the smoothie can be consumed in two versions. Drinking smoothie, liquid, like as I did, or eating smoothie. Then when you want a smoothie to increase the density, then you add seeds and cereals, and then you have a complete meal. If you want to do that, that's fine. You can throw some seeds there, cashews, all the seeds that the lady has recommended. That's the form of eating the smoothie. But if you want to drink the smoothie besides something else, that, so you have two versions. Depends what mood am I today in the morning, yes? Yes, madam, please. Yes, yeah, it's recommended organic foods. Yeah, this is because organic is organic, okay? It's not GMO, it's not pesticides, even though chemicals in the plants release in the soil, 90% of the chemicals goes down because of the water issue. But in the meats, when you have, you are dealing with growth hormones in the chicken, in the beef, and other antibiotics against cancer, that's a mess. Everything stays there. So meat diet will increase the cancer risk for population. Yes. Yeah. I think, yes, so the question is more practical, yes. My social condition, compare it with my pocket, it's realistic, correct? So I do suggest that if you look in websites of the farmers that are doing organic, instead of buying the store, you go drive your car, buy a big quantity, freeze that organic stuff, and you, I believe, at the end of the year, you save big thousands of money, dollars. Thank you very much, gentlemen. I'm sorry?
Some more smoothie?
Yes, if you would have a pleasure, it's my delight to serve you until the next section is prepared. So if you don't mind, we have the smoothie. We do the... Yes, we do another one. So if... This is better. So for the sake, you feel free to serve yourself with a smoothie like that, and we do another can. And meanwhile, we have the other lady that is preparing the section or part number two. Any other question regarding this? I think it's clear, yes? I'm 80 pounds less than before. I'm happy. I do my push-ups. By the way, I love my kids and my wife. And when we looked at the pictures back in time and they saw me like a zombie like that, they said, Dad, I'm so embarrassed with the way that you looked. Even my kids don't like the way that I used to be. So it is make a move, do the change, and you will be happy. Thank you very much. And by the way, please serve yourself a smoothie. And I will try to create a little bit another... Yes, I will add some bananas too. This time I would like add some bananas too. Banana, it's very good. What's that?
Use rice malt for this, right?
Was that? Rice, yes, it's rice, yes. Yeah, so what is very important, do you know the Africans are happier than us? Did you notice that? Oh yeah, okay, good. Do you know that Africans are happier than us? Why? Because they eat bananas and nuts all the day long, and they stay at sunshine, and they enjoy a lot of vitamin D. So for those who suffer depression, I recommend bananas a lot because it's very rich and stimulates serotonin, okay? So bananas every day, it's instead of, if you have a problem with consuming bread, take banana. It's like bread. So if you have banana in your smoothie, one banana per day, that will make you laugh more, and your spouse will be surprised. What do you do? Did you take some medication? No, I take a banana per day. So I will take this, okay? I will put some red stuff. You know, this is our Heavenly Father. God created beautiful colors to our fruits to be more attractive. Where is the rice? Oh, the rice. Thank you. Thank you very much. In the morning, I want to tell you until I do this business. At home, I had an opposition to change my diet because my family cooks traditionally. And they said, man, we cannot eat like you for the time being. So what I did, I woke up 7 o'clock in the morning. I went to establish the rules. I prepared the breakfast for everybody. So they were happy. Everybody came there. They saw smoothie. They changed a little bit of opinions. And after that, we can use a little bit of agave or maple syrup. We avoid sugars. In the worst case scenario, you can take honey if you like. You know, that stay natural as much as possible. You know, that those who have a strong flavor and is more lenient to sweet, can add a little bit of agave if it's necessary. You see, we have the fruits. The breakfast is easy, very, very easy. My friends, my wife cooked all her life. And when I had to say, hey, let's take a walk to the park, you know, she says, hon, I'm so tired. Why should I keep my wife in the kitchen when I can cook for her and we can be happy, correct? You know, do some fruits. In the afternoon, no much cooking. A big pot of salad, greens. We need the greens too, okay? You know, so we are happy. Spend less time in the kitchen, more time in nature. Family does not have experience divorce. Kids are happy. Nothing is better than daddy shows tenderness to mommy, correct? Kids are very happy. Mommy loves daddy, daddy loves mommy. So back to nature, back to Eden, back to the Word of God, I think will be a different lifestyle. Thank you very much. My stage is finished for next time, maybe in another time, if we would like to enroll ourselves in organized cooking classes, we may see each other again and experience more. Thank you, and thank you for the time that you sacrificed, left your family's home, and you came here. I really appreciate the gesture, and I hope that you will not be disappointed until the end of this presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We are finished with Livia's presentation. I hope you all enjoyed it. Next time when we all get together, it's going to be just pure cooking. This time we just wanted to introduce some nutrients and how to eat properly. And his living example, we see how much he lost. So I think we are all motivated with that. However, if you think that becoming a vegetarian and eating lots of pasta and lots of potatoes and rice and everything, you're not going to lose weight. Everything has to be in moderation. Now we are going to have some real cooking. And a friend of mine that I already sampled all of my life her food. She is a great cook, great baker. She really knows what she's doing. Vicky, are you ready?
No, I never used it.
I'm you supposed better be to ready. This. We are I don't ready know how for you.
It's good. Okay, this is friend of mine, Vicky.
Thank you.
You need help on here.
Okay, I'll need lots of help. I'm not okay. As good as Livia is at these things. I make a little bit more stronger food. So for those that want to have a bit more hearty food, then
they work physically hard.
Exactly. Or even, you know, I mean, we all like that. It's okay to have a breakfast like that. I'll show you something for lunch or dinner. How about that? Okay, today we have chosen to show you a gluten roast. Anybody here who is gluten intolerant, you can take gluten, right? Okay, so we will have in the future classes, we'll have a gluten-free recipes. And we do have them.
Next week,
yeah, she'll have a gluten-free recipes. You could modify this, but I'm doing for you. But I think, you know, it's for most of the people, it's something that's very simple. Now, I have a business, so I'm a very busy woman. I don't have time to cook too much, but I enjoy cooking and baking. So I prepared this. This is a gluten roast. At the end, it looks like this. Okay, it's like that. You can use it in many ways, different ways now. This has a, if you count calories, it has a quite a bit, but it is no frying, it is no, you know, lots of stuff. Everything is like organic stuff and things like that. So let's start with the recipe, I think, and then you can ask questions, whatever we need. So let's find the recipe. Okay, it calls for basic, sorry, just one second, let me do this. If you can just spray this one, there is a spray there. So because most of the gluten recipes are very time consuming and many people don't eat that. Now this takes case of instead of your roasts, you know, the beef roasts and things like that, this is really, it takes place instead of meat, really. And lots of people really like that. So I hope you will like it too. Now in our recipe, oh, this too, I don't know. I feel like I'm going on a moon. So with all these things, I'm not good with this.
You never know.
With this stuff, yeah. So anyway, let me just do this. So we have measured our beans. Now, if you're busy, you don't have to have your own cooked beans, right? It's a red beans. You can take a can of beans if you want, or any red beans. I am not so much to do that, but if some of you need to, if you have a slow cooker, put some beans in the evening, in the morning you have your own beans, and it tastes much better. So I'm just putting the cooked beans in here. Now this is my recipe. I call it a basic recipe because it is really basic to what we use in here. So it calls about 3 cloves of garlic and 2 cups of cooked beans. Okay, 1 large onion, that's all in here. So to prepare and to go faster, we have already cut up everything that we need. If you don't like as much garlic, take it out. You can use seasonings that you like, really. But this is just what I use. We like lots of onions and lots of garlic, so we will do that. And here. I was very blessed this morning. I had my mom and my sister-in-law help me chop up things, so that works out well for us. This here, I have, it's walnuts, and I do like walnuts with red kidney beans. This can be done with different beans. I've done garbanzo with different nuts, and I think you will enjoy trying. If you have a basic recipe and basic stuff, you can change your own what you like to put. I put some walnuts in. I like walnuts in anything that I do. Okay, now we have walnuts, soya sauce, and a pinch of salt. So I have a soya sauce here, some salt. Pinch of salt I have in here. Now, this is we have salt and 1.5 cups of water. I measured water and I put it in here. Okay, I'm not gonna spill this one. So I put it all in here. When you do it at home, you do it so fast because you don't have to, you know. Oh yeah, it helps a lot to put it in there. Thank you. You know, you need friends wherever you go, whatever you do. It's good. Now, salt again. I salted my beans whenever they were cooking, so I don't need to do too much of a salt. Okay, so I think we should cover it, don't you think so?
Maybe.
Yeah. I don't think we want to wear it. So, let's see.
Did everyone have a sample smoothie? You did.
To do in here. Okay, so let's open up this. Okay, in our bowl, we are going to put the flour. And this is why I find it very easy. This is the gluten flour. Now, this is the trick to this recipe, or any gluten recipe. You have to be very quick by mixing it. Otherwise you get lumps and it doesn't look good, okay? So let's try and open this. It's very liquidy. I pour it all in. Okay. And just mix it. I like it actually a bit more crunchy, So for me, I like the nuts and beans and to be a bit more crunchy. But, you know, if you like it really smooth, you can really have it smooth. I made this in my own, I make it in a blender. It doesn't have to be a strong component because you have a water in there. See how thick it gets? It gets really thick because gluten really, really gets it in. I do make this with the gluten-free flour too. You know, you can try that. And there is a lot, you know. Use maybe chickpeas instead of this with the gluten-free flour and it really works. There we go. And it's all done. So, what I'm using is two of this. Yeah, I need one more. So you can get the bigger ones or a smaller ones, but I use two of this, and it comes out like that. You can even make smaller ones, and whichever, you just, okay, half and half, please. Yes, ma'am. Okay. You have to put it in the oven. I bake mine on 385, 390 for about 40 minutes, but you will see when it's done. You can see, everybody's oven is different and things. But it's, like I say, we really enjoy it. It's very easy. I'm gonna need this one. So that is our gluten. That's all we have to do. We bake it, we don't fry it. Most of the time it's fried and cooked and all kinds of stuff. So this is the easiest way. You just bake it.
That's how it looks when it's in.
Yeah.
And then
it's, this is the finished product. Okay? What I didn't do, okay. Nothing. That's okay. I didn't think it was good to do something else. Okay, I'm gonna just have this moved. Thank you. Is that easy?
Yes, I agree. Anybody
can do that. Now, you can serve this in small slices in your sandwiches. You can serve it in your stir fry. You can put it in your salads if you want for a lunch. People cut this in squares and put it in their lunch with the salad, and that's your protein that you need with your salads. So it's really versatile that you can do. We enjoy doing them with the mushroom sauce. So, yes. Now, I need, let's move this over here, I guess. So we're going to do a mushroom sauce. I think most of you know how to do a mushroom sauce. Do you? Do you make mushroom sauce? Okay. This is the way I do mine. I don't know how everybody else does it, but that's the way I do mine. Okay, and the mushroom sauce, we have a recipe for that too someplace. That's fine. Okay. Because honestly, at home, I don't measure everything like that. I just, you know, after you do it so many times. And I want you to feel free. I really want you to enjoy cooking. That's why recipes are very good, but use the recipe as something as basic. Don't in cooking. In baking, maybe you need to make sure certain things. But I think even with this, you can put your own seasonings in, you know. I actually didn't put some on the, I have, my mother makes like a, almost like a, like you would use like a chicken or vegetable soup mix. She makes from our own garden, she dries the carrots and the celery and parsnip and, you know, everything. And then she, cuts them fine, dries them, and then we just blend it a little bit, and we make our own seasoning. And it really tastes very good, okay? But you can use something else. If you like some red paprika, you can put in, or omit what you don't like, you know, as long as you have something to eat. I don't need that. Yeah, thank you. So, right now, Milena, can you put this on for me? I need this. So, I don't know if we have time to really make the sauce, but we will go through it. Exercise, make it. It can be one, but yeah. My mother said I only have two on and high. That's off and high. That's about it. I'll put a little bit of oil in. I don't put too much because when you put the mushrooms in, now these are mushrooms. We have sliced mushrooms, a little bit of oil. Yeah. And I'm going to put, you can put onion first, but you, in this case, you can put both. Sorry. Okay, now, when I put salt on the mushrooms, they will let the water down. Now, where's my salt? Yeah, I think we
just need a second.
Because they will let the water go down, so it's not really frying. It's almost a pain, you know, in there. If you find that it doesn't have enough, just add a touch of water till it starts. It's, the point is not to fry, not to get the oil too hot, and that's what you're trying to avoid. So these are very finely chopped. You can have them chopped on the machine, or you can have them, you know, a little bit. I really don't mind even bigger slices. I don't mind. So, I don't know, like this. This is sea salt, by the way, and we use sea salt only for that. So if you can saute that.
Yep.
This flour. And I will put some of the soy sauce on that. I use this. I don't know, you can use any kind that you like, but some people have different preferences. I'm not just like that. If you like more, you can put more. You know, whatever you like. I think that's what we need for there, for now, and that needs to just be sautéed.
Our time is running out. Yeah.
No, but I think we are running out of time. So what I will do, I'm going to just pretend that this is done. Is that okay? Can we do that? Okay.
At home, don't pretend.
Yeah.
It won't.
Actually,
taste good.
It won't, but it's okay. You just won't have that roasted feeling in the, you know. But it will be okay. Now I'm using rice milk in here because I think it's something that's versatile. You can actually use just water. If you want to, you can use just water. You don't even have to use any milk if you're looking at calories and things like that. But it gives it a bit nicer taste. Now, rice milk is the most, I would say, blah taste. Sorry.
Bland
taste. But
don't say
blah taste. Okay? Because you need something that will be there but not there, and that's what this milk does. Even in your sweet baking, using rice milk, it really gives you that base, a tendency of milk, but not really milk thick, right? So, if this was almost done,
it is.
Yeah, it's done. Okay, see, I just want to show you, see how much water there is? You get lots of water when you do them like this.
Mushrooms release.
Because they're in the small pieces, so they just release the water. So if this was done, I'm just going to put 1 or 2 tablespoons of flour. This is unbleached flour.
And why are you doing this?
Just to thicken it.
Okay.
I'll thicken that a little bit. Then we are going to use... Now, I'm using tofutti sour cream. I don't know, does anyone know what this is? It's tofu, but it's sour cream. The tofu sour cream. Okay? It's white, nice, tastes good.
If you are vegan, you are going to use that as and it tastes like a real sour cream.
In any case, you can't find this. You don't need this. You're okay with just the flour. Just you have to add a little bit more of seasonings if you like. Okay? So this one, we are just gonna put this in. Just really good. And as you see, there's not much oil in this. I've actually made it without oil, too, because, it, like I said, if you're... So now, and this is a bit slower than your stuff at home. So this is... Sorry. So this, you can see the consistency of that, okay? So now, I want to use this to pour over... Can you bring the finished one, if you mind? So I've used this, I put it in my baking dish, and I put a little bit of sauce underneath, and then I put layers, I layer them up on that, nice, on that, and then I pour the sauce over. Now, the sauce has to be, sorry.
Oh, what is going on?
I still don't know.
I move and...
I know, I can't live without her, I can't live without her. You know, she knew I needed help. She came all the way from Europe to live here so I can continue my life.
And actually today all the way from Brampton, Ontario.
That's right. Just to be
just
to make
to
sure
help her.
To make sure I'm in one piece. You know. Anyway. So this I put rice milk and you can see, look at the consistency. And this is how it works.
And
I put it in the oven and I bake it.
And we are going to taste it pretty soon.
Yeah,
right?
We'll taste it soon. Yeah.
Okay, so
I'm just
gonna
take
it back.
You can actually if you can warm it up a bit.
Okay.
Okay. If you eat it fresh. Now, very good thing about this recipe is that you can make this and freeze it. You take it out of the freezer and it's just as good. Okay? This I wouldn't freeze. Now, if you are coming home, your family needs to eat, you have this frozen, defrost this, put it on, put tomato sauce on, and just warm it up. And tomato sauce, lots of people have finished tomato sauce already. I just need a little, you know, just like that. Okay, now, if you like parsley, I wouldn't put carrots, I find them too sweet with this. Parsley is okay. Some people have put dill. I like dill, but not everybody does. So I've done just basic for you, so you have an idea. And it's really good. See, it tastes really, really nice. And that's it. Okay, so it just has to cook. That's it.
So I guess she's finished with her presentation. Yes. As I said today, it's not much cooking, more talking. Next time there'll be more cooking. It's really nice to have all of you here. Now we are going to sample the food. We do have some stuff such as salad and mashed potato, I believe, that goes with roast really good. And everyone knows how to do mashed potato. We don't need to show you how to do that or salad. In cooking, it's very good to have good imagination. Whatever you think would work with your dish, try it out. If it's not good, well, next time don't put that in that particular dish. Anyway, we are at the end of it. Just be patient for a few minutes because they will start dishing out the salad. Now, on this side, yeah, she's still wired up. On this side, we have some books perhaps they're recipes or help books, how to eat and whatnot. So if you would like, the beautiful girl there, she is going to help you out with them.
Or if you have questions, we can talk.
Yes. So I don't know what's happening. They're kind of slow. Are we ready?
Not yet.
They're not ready. You want to say something, yeah. Still?
If you have questions, we are here to. So do you find simple and saving time for the ladies to cook these kind of... Any questions for you tonight? Would you like to participate to our next session? What do you think? I mean, it's for free. I know that in society today, everything that is for free, it's a big question mark. Nobody gives you anything for free, correct? But I want to tell you, we travel all over the world, and I've been in China, in a city, in a village, 2.7 million in one village. They eat everything that flies outside of helicopters and airplanes. You know, bats, cats, dogs, rats, snakes, everything. It's crazy. I want to tell you guys, life expectancy in China is 45 years of age. We call that yellow race or something, according to, it's not yellow, it's the liver. They have a sick liver. So they have a chronic hepatitis in the Chinese civilization, in Asian countries as well. And the child is born with a sick liver. That's why the highest rate of accidents, car accidents in North America, Canada, and United States are produced by Asians. Why? Because once you get damage the liver will affect your reflexes, your sightness, you have a problem with seeing things, and all your reflexes. So the highest rate of accidents is because of that. So when the liver is sick, the pigment of your skin is changing. So it's not a yellow race, it's a sick liver that goes from generation to generation. And maybe you will think, is there another population that has lower life expectancy than China? Yes, is the Eskimos, 35 years of age. And when you relate their lifestyle with food and life expectancy, you will realize that indeed food has something to do with the extension of life. So the Eskimos are living around 35 years of age because they are eating only meat, raw meat, no fruits, no vegetables. At 35 years of age, they are old and they have no dentistry, no teeth at all. And they pass away. So, yeah, we thank you very much for coming. Really appreciate your presence. Hopefully you will enjoy the tasty food that we have. And I think that if we open a restaurant, we will have a lot of clients, I am assuming. So we are here anytime you have a thought or a question, feel free to address to us, and we are willing to cooperate with you. Thank you very much, and enjoy the year.
I hope you do not mind me interrupting, but it is my custom and the custom of some of our people here to say grace before we have our food. So would you be agreeable to that?
Sure.
Okay. Doreen, would you be kind enough as a host to say grace? Thank you.
Father in heaven, and thank you, Jesus. We thank you for this word, and we ask you to nourish all of us. We are in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.